Howdy. I'm your friendly realtor, Shannon. I help property owners, purchasers, and investors turn their dreams and passions into profitable possibility. Well, this is the weekly market update for March 4th through March 10th, 2024. Shannon, what are this week's numbers saying? That's a great question, Shannon. I'm glad you asked. Single-family homes, residential active homes, these are the ones you can purchase this week at 606, up from 29 homes from 577. Next down on this side is closed homes. This is the number of homes closed this past week. Last week we had 67 at the end of the month. This week we have 21 for the first of the month. Not surprising. Pending homes. Some say these are sold homes, but they're pending and under contract and not close. This means something could fall through between contract and closing till all parties sign on that dotted line. Nothing's final. Last week it was 334. This week it's down a net of 5 to 327. So over here, medium close price took a major dip from last week's 241,755, and it's now 210 this week. That's a 13% price drop. Over here, we're coming up to list to sales price ratio. This is the average original marketed price on the MLS compared to what it closed for at the title company after all the dust settled. So this indicates, are sellers getting what they're asking for? Are they overpricing it? It has increased the gap from 94.7% to 93.3%. Based on what they're looking for, the ask price and the close gap is widening. So what that means is sellers need to do more to be in tune with the market for pricing of their home from the start, or improve the condition to make the repairs and the properties to meet the listed price when compared to the condition of other properties. 93 is the days on market and in our MLS. This means the day it goes on the MLS until it closes at the title company. This indicates whether we're in a buyer's, a balanced, or a seller's market, and we are in a seller's market. However, last week, the average days on market was 88, so this is an increase of the homes sitting on the market a week longer on average, and days on market would improve as sellers would further declutter and stage their homes. Most are not, so they're sitting longer. Look. We're going up above me. These are the rates brought to us by our preferred lender and fabulous mortgage lender, Central Bank's Elizabeth Riggins. We're going to go left to right, starting with conventional. Wow, rates took a drop this week. With conventional, it went from 7.6 to 6.9. That's a 0.7% decrease. FHA went from 7.1 to 6.5, and VA dropped from 7.1 to this week's 6.75. We have seen the interest rates take at least a half a point drop after creeping up over 7%. If inflation gets under wraps, economist Lawrence Yun says we should see 3 to 5 rate decreases by the Federal Reserve over 2024. And for compliance, Elizabeth reminds me to say that interest rates will vary depending on each person's purchase price and financial profile. Shannon, is now a good time to buy? Well, yes, in two categories. It absolutely is. If you have a need, and two, if you're a renter. But Shannon, I have a 3% interest rate. I'm stuck in this home. I need to move, but it's so cheap. I could never move. They're going to have to pry it out of my cold hands. Well, that could be the case if you purchased and sold homes like everyone else. But because you know me, I've learned how to help folks just like you get into a home with my systems to number one, buy with the least amount out of pocket as possible. Two, in the most convenient way to you. Three, in the fastest time possible. And four, with the overall lowest possible property ownership price to be able to get into it, even with the current interest rates. I have tools that buyers are using to help leverage the market and their purchase so they aren't handcuffed to their mortgage rate. And if you know someone who's in that situation, please send them this video. There's still some great deals in the market. My contact information is right up here. And if there's any questions that you have or you don't understand some of the information that I'm providing, I'd love to have an opportunity to have a quick chat. Reach out and let me know. Like and comment if you enjoyed the content and share this video with someone you care about. Let fear be the passenger, not the driver in your life. And I'll see you next week.